Joining us today is Mallika, Guzy, Arbor Ventures co-founder and managing partner, to talk about fintech, funding, and female representation in the VC industry. Mallika, welcome. You know, Mallika, many studies show us repeatedly that it makes business sense to have women in very senior levels of leadership in the finance industry, but yet in the VC industry, the number of senior women remains stubbornly low. Why is that?
Well, I think you're exactly right. I mean, when 50% of the purchasing power in the world is in the hands of women, mm-hmm. it makes just great business sense to have a woman's perspective. And so why does it remain stubbornly low is because most people come into the VC industry through having done a startup. And if you look at the number of women who are founders in startups or head of product marketing or head of engineering, which is the normal path, it's also very, very low. And so you just don't have the flow of women coming up through the ecosystem that you have had with men over the years. It's changing, but it's changing very slowly.
When we talk about funding also, I think it's almost 80%, that around 80% of VC money goes to startups founded by men. And women get a very small piece of the VC pie. How do we address that?
Well, I think it's two things. One, I think just the number of startups founded by women is significantly lower than those that are founded by men. So you just don't have the pool that are coming through the system. And also, I think when you're sitting in a room and you're a young woman and you're presenting to a group of men, I think, you know, perhaps, you know, you're not somehow connecting with them, or maybe the business plan that you have is more geared towards women than necessarily maybe men. Whatever it is, we need much more diversity inside the partners' rooms and venture capitalists, and I think that will help. But I get back to the fundamentals, which is we need more women in startups today.
So again, if we take a step back, to get more women in startups, do we need more women studying computer science, studying tech, studying different subjects, a bigger variety of subjects in school and colleges? How do we encourage more women to create startups?
Well, we need women coding.
Girls who code, you need to start young.
You got to start young. We need women who are studying math and sciences, whether it's computer science or statistics or math in college.
STEM.
Exactly. And then the other part about it is we need women to want to take risk. Women tend to be much more risk adverse than men are at that age. And we need to encourage women that it's okay to take the risk. It's okay to fail. It's okay to try again. And that, you know, if you try and you don't succeed, that's, you know, a badge that's not honorable. It's very honorable in Silicon Valley. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So I think we need to encourage not only what people study, but also what they strive to achieve, and also be able to take the risk to go to a startup, which ultimately can lead to becoming a venture capitalist.
One area, one market where women have actually been quite successful in the VC industry is China. What lessons can we learn from the ecosystem there that's allowed this to happen?
Well, I think it's historical. I mean, China being a communist country was far more gender-free than the United States or Europe. And so women were in positions of influence and power. And so you didn't have as much gender bias in China, I think, because of that. I think where we're going now in the US and Europe is trying to mandate equality. But mm-hmm. equality actually comes from great leadership. So a great CEO in a startup will make sure that he has a well-balanced team. And I think the more and more people are educated that having diversity in a company is very important, you'll naturally see the progression happen, at least in the US and Europe. In Southeast Asia particularly, and in China, we don't have this barrier to entry that you have in the US and Europe.
Speaking of China, I know you focus on fintech, and I wanted to ask you, do you think China's fintech giants like Alibaba and Tencent have the potential to evolve into regional giants, and what will that look like?
Well, I mean, traditionally, the way, if you look at venture capital returns, they haven't been dependent upon global expansion. So when you think about the U.S., the reason that venture returns have come out of the U.S. is because it's a big market. The same thing goes for China. It's a big market. You actually never need to leave China to become a highly valuable company, which has been proven. I think with the fintech giants, what has happened is China has led the way when it comes to payments and mobile banking. And I think regardless whether they go regional or not, which is yet to be seen, and they are trying, their influence on the rest of the world has been tremendous.